When we talk about the spirit of man, we're talking about the nature of man, the character of man, the personality of man, the essence of man, the intrinsic essence of man. What makes man different from other spirits? When God was to create man, he said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness. He's talking about spiritual creation. It's not about physical, it's not about body, no. It's talking about spirit. You are a spirit, and the earlier you recognize this, the better. Now, when you recognize that you are a spirit, you walk towards the enhancement of your spirit. You feed your spirit man. Because the time that you spend taking care of your physical body, if you use the same thing to take care of your spirit man, your life will never remain the same. The spirit of man, Proverbs 18 and verse 14. The spirit of a man will sustain his infirmity. But a wounded spirit,
who can bear?
Proverbs 20 and verse 27. Proverbs 20 and verse 27. The spirit of man is the candle of the Lord, searching all the inward parts of the belly. Zechariah chapter 12 and verse 1. Zechariah 12, 1. The burning of the word of the Lord for Israel, saith the Lord, which stretched forth the heavens and laid the foundation of the earth and formed the spirit of man within him. He formed what?
The spirit of man within him.
The spirit of man is about the nature, the personality, the character, the individuality of man. It is about the ingrained or inherent or intrinsic essence of man. Man is an individuality. You are different. And when it comes to man again, there are also different spirits. In the course of studying for this message, I said, no wonder. As we are all seated here like this, as we are all here like this, we are all different spirits because we are all individuals. My spirit is different from the spirit of my wife because my personality is different from that from her own, even though we are married. That's why our fingerprint is different. Go and ask the scientists, they will tell you that your fingerprint cannot be duplicated. That means you can never be a clone of another person. You are just simply you. Because I saw that there is a spirit called the spirit of Elijah. The spirit of Elijah rested upon Elisha. Why? Due to the ministry of relationship. Anybody you relate with, you company with, that person's personality will rub off on you. That person's character will rub off on you. That's why the Bible says, if you move with the wise, you'll be wise. If you also move with the foolish, you'll be foolish. Elijah and Elisha, they had a ministry relationship. A mentor-mentee relationship. And so the spirit that was in existence, or the personality of Elijah, was reflected in the life of his protege, Elijah.